Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, a question sent in by Wybab. Wybab sent in a data set and said we need to create a pivot table from this data set. The data set has month, a debit credit field, document number, and then three numeric fields, service tax, CES, and SHES. And once the doc number is going down the left-hand side, and then the outermost column field is month, then the debit credit field, and then within that, the three data fields. So this is a little bit tricky to create with a pivot table. Basically, we'll come over here to our data set, use data, pivot table, click next for the first two steps, and I'm going to build it right here on the existing worksheet so I can kind of have a model to follow. Click finish. Okay, so we know that we want doc number going down the left-hand side, the row fields. That's the easy part. And then the column fields, we're going to take the month first, debit credit next, and then our three data fields, service tax, CES, and SHES. Drop those in the data area. Okay, now, what do we have to do? A couple of things. First of all, every accountant knows debit's on the left, credit's on the right, and of course it puts them alphabetically. Well, it's very easy to reverse this. It's amazing. We can either drag and drop that, or I just come here and type the word debit, press enter, and Excel figures out what we're trying to do. Never do that in regular Excel. It only works in pivot tables. It actually reverses and puts debit first and credit last. We do not want monthly totals, so I'm going to double click the month heading and say none. Click OK. All right. And then the big problem we have back in Excel 2003 is when we have multiple fields in the data area, they always go down the left hand side, but we want these going across the top. So I'm going to take the data heading and drag it here to the last column area. And so now let's check. We have our first month, and then debits, service tax, CES, SHES, credit, service tax, CES, SHES, and then start with the next month. So it's looking pretty good. A couple of things I would still do to clean this up. First thing, I hate that the fact that they use headings like sum of service tax, so I choose each one of those, press the blue field settings, and basically get rid of the word sum of, but then we have to type a space at the end. You can't call it service tax, we already have a field called service tax, but service tax space works just fine, so I'll do that for each one of those fields. Space, and then SHES, space. And then the other thing, and this is just annoys me personally, is I really want zeros in here. This is a fairly sparse data set. I don't want blanks in all my numeric columns, so I right click on the pivot table and choose table options, and then say for empty cells, show zero. Click OK, and there we go. We have something that matches the model sent in by Wybab. So it's possible with a pivot table. A little bit, some arcane things along the way, reversing the debit and credit, and getting those data fields to go across the top instead of down the side. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.